All know that UPSC AIC is toughest examination in India. So you need to have a determined study as well as a proper plan and strategy for cracking this examination. And nowadays, competition is huge and railway vacancies are also removed from AIC. So please be careful with AIC because I know there are so many people who are preparing for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years even. They are preparing for 10 years. They have started their preparation from graduations and they are preparing. So you should be very careful in your preparation. Have a proper strategy planning and give a better execution for this AIC. Okay. So, and IRMS is still states like it is not confirmed. Let's hope for the best. So we'll see, will IRMS release this notification or not? So we can wait and see. But AIC preparation is entirely different from state government examinations, because for state government examinations, SSC, JEE, you don't need this much determination for in studies. AIC syllabus is vast and you can't predict the questions also. So there are major subjects, minor subjects, even they can ask many questions from the minor subjects and minor topics. So it is really unpredictable. So we should be very careful and we should always need to study everything. You can't even left a single topic or single subject. But maybe in 5 months, let's see how we can prepare. So you need at least 1 year for completing this AIC syllabus. So, but leave that, whatever it is, past is first. You have 5 months now. Okay, so you have almost 5 months, like February, March, April, May, June, July. So most probably July 18 will be your AIC examination. And there will be chance for postpone also, because UPSC, AIC is really unpredictable. And there may be chance for this IRMS notification also. So it's really unpredictable, so they may change. It depends. So whatever it is, assume that you have 5 months, approximately 5 months left for your AIC examination. And if your goal is AIC, then please don't leave. As well as if your goal is AIC, don't leave another job also. Don't quit your private job or any other government job. And don't please quit and study, because nowadays AIC is quite unpredictable and number of vacancy is reducing. Okay, so please don't quit your job and study. You can prepare with job. Okay, so let's begin how to prepare in this 5 months. So we have February, March, April, May, July. Okay, so don't consider July. So this is, you can consider it as a buffer time. And some will be saying like in 5 months we can't crack examination, but nothing is impossible. If you crack in 5 months, you can say that we can crack ESC in just 5 months. So, but the problem here is your ESC prelims will be on July. After 2 to 2.5 months, you are having mains examination. So you don't have that 6 months in between this prelims and mains. So you should prepare how to write your answers in mains. So mains preparation should be started from March or maximum at April. Okay, you should practice mains questions also, because it's not like if you qualify prelims, that mark will be added as well as mains mark will be added, then interview mark will be added. So just start preparing from now onwards. Okay, for interview also, for mains also, don't concentrate more on interview now. Just concentrate on mains and prelims now, because you have only 2.5 months, which is very, very less time for this prelims and mains. And cracking prelims in this situation is really hard. Vacancy is very, very less. And this less vacancy, the competition is very high. Competition is huge. People are really working hard. So you should also work hard for cracking this. And the problem is you are not having technical part. You are also having general studies part. So technical plus non-technical. So be prepared for your examination. Okay. So until nothing is, you should try. So first you should believe in yourself. You should know what are the major subjects. This is just, we can predict that these are the major subjects. But structure subjects are mostly asked in this AIC examination. The weightage of structure subjects is a little high when comparing to non-structure subjects. It is not the case in GATE examinations. The GATE and AIC is different. And you can expect theory questions, you can expect conceptual questions. You can expect numerical, that too without calculators. You should practice from now onwards. You should remember values like root 2, root 3, as well as cube roots. So start remembering all these things. So let's see what are the major subjects. So SOM, soil, environment, fluid, transportation. This fluid contains hydraulic machines and open channel flow. So these are all major subjects in this AIC examinations. And we can't say all subjects are important. Even in some year they may ask more questions from irrigation, they may ask more questions from hydrology. It's really unpredictable. But we can just say that weightage is little more in this subject. So prepare more on this exam, the subjects, not only the subjects. So start preparing. Beginning of your preparation should be with your major subjects. For example, if you are starting from February, you should start with SOM. Okay, or you can start this building materials is also very important. Building materials and construction is also very important. You can't skip that also. It has huge weightage in ESC examination. Okay, so we can see if you're preparing, you should start with two subjects. So daily studying one subject, like if you're starting with SOM, studying SOM, it will be really boring and you can't study it for a long time. So for number of days also, you should fix the number of days. For example, for SOM, you need 15 days. You can fix like that. For soil, you need more number of days. Maybe it can take up to 25 days. So it depends on your caliber. And talking about this environment and building materials, you should not take for like 15 days or 20 days. Read daily. Allow 1 to 2 hours for this environment and building materials. And just read. Okay, so read this mains answers. Okay, read this theory from this mains question and answer. Try answering this main question from now onwards, or you can from this main answers. For example, if you are reading this environment, just take that particular chapter. For example, water quality parameters, you can see the subquestions asked in this mains. So start reading from that and mark important things, highlight what is important and what is not, and study. That's all that's needed for that is only needed for this theory subjects. So ESC contains technical as well as non-technical. That is non-technical means GS part. So technical, you know how to prepare or not. So first, you should complete your preparation in this 4 months. Like start, if you couldn't complete also, just complete all the major subjects as well as important topics. There are many important topics in a subjects. If you don't know what are the important topics in a subjects, you can ask me. Definitely will help you what are the important topics in a subject. So you can be selective also. You should select which is important and which is not. No need to cover 100% of your syllabus. There is no need to cover this 100% of your syllabus, because you need to qualify prelims. Okay, so you can skip also. You can skip many topics. Start from important subjects. For example, start from structure subjects. You should definitely start from SOM. After studying this SOM only, you can study RCC. Then only you can study structure analysis. So these are all related. You can't start with structure analysis without studying SOM. You can't start RCC without studying structure, strength of materials. So please have a connection on this. Okay, so don't leave topics. These topics, please don't leave. So the subjects also, please don't leave. So these are important subjects in ESE. So please try to cover 100% syllabus in the subjects. You can skip very, like there will be a chapter which is least important. So you can skip that part, but try to cover everything from the subjects. Okay. These are called minor subjects or less important subjects. Okay, so theory is also important. I'm not saying theory is not important, but while it is not like we can't predict questions from states, so it is time consuming also. So that's why I'm written here. And geology, you can skip also. Engineering mechanics, you can skip. That is not included in syllabus, but you can skip engineering mechanics. And construction project management, you should not skip. Just study construction project management, because it will help in this general studies part. There is a subject called project management in general studies part. So don't skip this construction project management. And hydrology and irrigation also. Sometimes you can expect more questions from irrigation. So sometimes you can expect more questions from hydrology also. So in a mains, I know that in a mains examination, there was 20 to 30 marks from irrigation only in examination. So it is really unpredictable. So just study according to this way. Okay. Next, maximum try to complete your syllabus in May itself. Try to complete all your syllabus in May itself. So you have almost 4 months. Definitely you can complete. Okay, definitely you can complete. Divide it into two. So daily you should allow 1 hour for this 1 hour for this environment and building materials, and 1 hour for this general studies, and 1 hour for max, and half an hour for this aptitude. Remaining hour should be for this technical. So your day should be divided like this only. So you should give equal preference to general studies from now onwards, because you have almost 5 months. So start studying general studies also. Don't skip. Start studying with max, aptitude. Then because then start with, I will say, which are subjects are in GS are more important. Okay, and there is a chance of postponed also, because maybe they can add this, they can recruit ESE and IRMS, they can recruit students. It is really unpredictable. There may be chance of this IRMS notification also. So maybe they can postpone. Maybe they can postpone ESE examination. And talking about general studies, I'm just studying only the scoring part. General studies has been introduced in 2017, and it is really unpredictable. Start with this energy and environment. So this is little easy subject while comparing to other, and it contains high weightage. So energy and environment is very important. It contains so many questions will be asked on this portion, and this is quite easy. You can just compare with environment and studies, environmental impact assessment and various pollutions and various policies. So it's very easy. And project management, so this is easy. You have already studied in the CPM technical, but you have already studied. Next is ICT. Study ICT, standard and quality, and material science. So this five subjects is more than sufficient. You can add six also. So at least start, at least you can score maximum mark from this subject and max and aptitude. So don't leave this part. So you can score more mark from at least from the subjects. You can even skip other also, because in this engineering drawing only one or two questions asked, that too in 2018 or 19 they have asked. So don't give more importance to all these things. Next, talking about this current issues. So current issues is really a vast topic. So it is changing. So don't waste your time in current issues. You can purchase magazine from any institutions like Medici or any other institutions. You can purchase this magazine. And you can just go through what are important events, important factors you need to study. That's all. That's more than sufficient for current issues. And you should have an integrated plan. That is, you should know what is important and what is not. And you should study two subjects per day. Then it won't be boring. Like you can study one major subject and one minor subject. Like this, you can group. Okay, for example, you can study strength of materials with hydrology or project management, and soil with environment or 4CF, and structure analysis with this transportation, RCC with survey, or RCC with this building materials. Okay, and there are some factors you need to consider to improve your concentration. First one is, it is very important sleep, because this is not a journey of 2 weeks or 2 days. If your examination is only have 1 day left, then you can like sleep less and study more. But this is a preparation of 5 months to 1 year. So you should not sacrifice sleep. If you sacrifice your sleep, then it's going to affect your results also. So please don't sacrifice this. It is very important. I know there are many people who have sacrificed their sleep to study, and at last they couldn't even write the examination only because of this lack of sleep. So there may be many videos in YouTube following you. You can score, you can study 16 hours or 18 hours with less sleep. Please don't believe in this blunders. You know, okay, you will definitely have many health issues if you are having irregular sleep cycle, or if you are sleeping less, definitely you will be having many health issues. So please don't sacrifice that. Next is, do 30 minutes to 1 hour physical exercise. That is also very important. You can do meditation, or you can do yoga, or you can do any kind of exercise. So this will boost your memory power. Okay, so this will increase your oxygen supply to your brain. So that is very much essential for your memory power and concentration. So do exercise also. Please have break. So if you're studying for 45 minutes or 15 minutes, have 10 minutes break. If you study for 1 hour, have 15 minutes break. So it depends on your capacity. So if you're not having this break, definitely it's going to affect your memory capacity, your concentration. So it will be affecting you only. So if you have regular breaks, then your brain will start learning new things with full concentration. You can learn with 100% capacity. And your study should be target based, not hour based. Okay, so for example, your target is to complete 2 chapters in this week or 3 chapters in this week. So try to complete this. Okay. Next is about this ASE examination. Minimum you need 9 to 12 months, not 11 to 12 months, minimum you need 9 to 12 months. But okay, we don't have time, so we can just try our best with less time. Next, prepare short notes. So this is also very important. Include these formulas in these short notes, and you should include important charts. You should include important concepts. So you should include every important things in the short notes. And you should have a long-term goal as well as short-term goal. So if your long-term goal is ASE, have a short-term goal like completing 2 to 3 subjects, completing 1 to 5 subjects. So you have short goals. And how to solve these objectives? So solving this objective is also a skill. Okay. If you are reading some concepts, or if you are studying some concept don't solve the questions right after that study. Try to solve after 2 to 3 days. So what is the advantage is you will have one cycle of this revision. After that, then you will be having the capacity to solve the objective questions. So try doing that. And strategy. So it depends on person to person. So I can't say you should follow the strategy or not. So it depends on person to person. So some may want to study from morning 6 o'clock. Some may some want to stay late. So it depends. So your strategy or like some are very good in structure subjects. Some are very bad in structure subjects. But in ASE you can't use structure subjects like GATE. So GATE and ASE is entirely different. Please don't get confused with these two. Don't miss previous year questions. You will get an idea how to answer the questions. So definitely you'll be practicing your main strategy from now, right? So just start attempting previous equations. Just plan for 6 days. So this one day should be break time or this buffer times, right? Have a plan on this 6 days. So you want to divide all the topics for 6 days only, not for 7 days, because it may get overload or you won't be completing your subjects or topics. So have every time you should have one day as buffer time, or you can take one day as break. So that your mind will be relaxed. Okay, so this I have already mentioned. Solve questions after 2 to 5 days of reading concepts. Next, you should not revise your class notes again and again. So it is a waste of time only. You should revise your you should revise STAMA questions. You should revise with mock tests, with previous equation solving, only with short notes, micro notes. So that should be your revision cycles, and you should follow parallel revision also. Next, if you are studying something, the content should be precise. That is very much important. If you are studying like without having that precise content and writing means, it will be waste for you also. So have a precise content, have a plan of 2 to 3 months. Okay, then start your preparation. Just spend 1 to 2 days for planning alone. Okay, not one to just spend your 3 days for planning, as well as your strategies, your strength, your weakness, and what should topic should be covered in month, in a day, in a week. Like this you should decide, and you should start solving mains questions from March. Okay, start solving this mains questions, take your questions and start writing. So or at least solve these questions from SOM or the structure subjects. Don't miss that. Next is in prelims. This GS part contains about 200 marks. So in that, scoring 90 to 100 mark is more than sufficient. Okay, try to score 90 to 100 mark. And this is sorting mistakes, like if you are not having proper plan, like weekly plan, that is Monday plan, 1 week plan, 2 months plans. So if you're not having that plan, definitely it's going to fail. So your strategy fails. Next, you should have proper revisions. Like you should have parallel revision. You should have daily revision. So that is also important. And if you're not understanding the concepts, it's not like SOCJE or the state government examination. So you should understand the concepts for solving questions. Okay. So that's all. Just try to allow 10 hours per day. Try to allow 10 hours per day. So in that, 1 hour for this max our aptitude, 1 hour for this environment, and this 1 hour for this general studies, okay, and 1 hour for mains questions, and 1 hour for revision. And you should study remaining five hours topics and concepts, because you have less time. So kindly plan according to that. Okay, all the best for your examinations. Just give your best. Thank you.